Hello. If my eyeshadow looks weird, it's because I've had it on. I was going to say all day, but no. But I've had it on for a while and I haven't recorded it. And I was not going to record this video, but I was. I said to myself, I will record my haul yesterday. Did not. I said to myself, I can do it today. I did not. And I was in bed and I was like, because my vacation ends today, so I start work tomorrow. But I said to myself, I can take out all the things that I'm going to have in my haul and then I can do it tomorrow. Because that was the hard part, because I've actually put everything in its place. And it looks like someone dropped a bomb in here. I don't like it, and I don't think I can have it like this till tomorrow. And then I thought about, because I'm picking up a package tomorrow, and I'm like, I can't wait for all my packages because they won't get here. And the things that are in, I think it is that package at least, the things that are in that are supposed to go with things from another package and so on. So I was like, just do it. And yeah, like I said, my makeup is crusty and things, but the alternative is that I wouldn't have any makeup. And I think I have all the stuff I have bought. I'm looking around. I think I have all the stuff here because I saved the boxes for everything and put in my, you know, this. And the things that didn't have boxes, I wrote down on a note. It looks so terrible here. But let's start. Just start and get it over with. And I'm going to start with some Blush Tribe things because I won a giveaway. And I won these four pigments. They don't look as bright in the camera as they are, maybe because I have locked the screen. Shouldn't I have locked the screen? But if I don't lock the light, I will get annoyed by it. But at the same time, I'm showing you stuff. Let's try. But yeah, these are the neon pigments, and I already have these neon pigments. There are no names on. There are names on the blue, and I know that's the same, but I already have these pigments, you know, because I have bought them. And I have promised my friend Carolina, it's so hard to change to Swedish, to get the yellow one because she's looking for a good yellow that will work on a darker skin tone. So I'm going to send this to her, but I said that I just wanted to have it in my video. And the other three, I will see what I'm going to do with those. But they are going in my drawer here. And you will probably have seen them in my makeup collection video because then I had everything organized, which I have not now. Annoying. But then I bought some other pigments. I bought the. It's like, I think they're all called some form of titanium dust, but it's blackberry and fruit punch. I'm not going to swatch them because they are pigments and it's messy, but I'm going to drop them. No, but it's like these, and it's not the same as the other blue, which doesn't show up well on the camera, but you just have to believe me that they are different. But yeah, so I bought these two. Then I bought two from, she has a collection. Is it called the Jungle Collection or something like that, with greens at least? And I bought two, Fern and Pine. It's hard to see, but they are different types of greens. Really pretty, like that. And then I bought Cad Khadija. I was going to say Khadija, but it doesn't say that. It's a peach. It's really hard to show you, but it's like a peach pink thing. So pretty. And then, of course, I have the ones you got with the Paulina palette and the Layla palette. I got one of them before, but I have the one you got from the Layla palette as well. And since there were trouble with getting these, let's see. Are these? Yes. Ooh. Sorry. There were trouble when I was getting these, so they weren't sent when I ordered my palettes or got my palettes. She sent them separately, and then I got two pigments for free. That was so kind. It's Genie, and I can see that it's pink and green. So cool. It's really hard to show you. I don't think it will show up at all, but it's really pretty at least. And then I have Himalaya. In Swedish, you would say Himalaya, right? I don't know, but it's pretty. So I bought a lot of pigments. And now I'm going to pause because I want to put them back. And I have so many different containers because I've gotten this for free another time. And it's another type of container. But yeah, so I'm going to pause you. Now I'm like, did I say that this is my monthly haul? But at the same time, that is the title. So. And this is all the things I have received since my last haul. But it's not everything I bought, unfortunately. Because there is so much stuff here. Yeah. Okay. Let's go to the side. I may have showed these in other videos, but yeah. I bought this from ColourPop. It's, you know, compact. And highlighter called Swirl, and I already have this, so I will probably give this away. It's really pretty, but I already have it in a palette I think I've showed you, and that is just so annoying, but yeah, I bought it, so that's why I'm showing you. Oh, I can show you this boring stuff as well. I was at Sephora in Denmark in Copenhagen. And they have such good customer service. And I got all these free samples. No. I received this in Sweden. Yeah, because I was so surprised. Because I actually met someone that had great customer service. But you know, I got these free samples. This is a blue clay mask. And from their own brand. And then we have Egyptian Magic All-Purpose Skin Cream. And to CC Red Correct from Herborian, I don't know. And their own waterproof eye makeup remover. Yeah. Then I bought this in Denmark. Woohoo, isn't it cute? I thought it was cute. So I'm going to put this in here for now. Like that. Then, I think I've showed you this already, what I bought in Denmark, but I bought this from MAC. They had a sale there, and it's the Fleuryl highlight powder, you know, the one that looks like this, and it's just a, what did we say that it was called? Overspray. And it looks like fabric when you look at it. So weird. But it's really pretty. God, I hate the light. But I will never touch it. But it's pretty. Then another thing I won't use is also from MAC. It's this. It's Color Me Nico, maybe. It looks like that. Nico. Panda, I don't know, but it looks like that. Really cute. I think it's a blush, I don't know, but I won't use it. But it's really pretty. I hate this light. And then, I don't even know where to start. I can take these. I'm just taking this random, okay? I was in H&M and, oh my god, the makeup in H&M is always looking like, I don't know. It always looks like there have been children playing, and probably has. Because the makeup looks ruined, and you know, the only, I have tried to buy these before, but the only ones that have been available have been open and used, obviously, and they don't clean it up. But yeah, it's their Glitterati mascara liner. I have two since before, and these are called Nebula, I don't know, and Starlight, and it's the ones that are, you know, it is a liner, but it's also a mascara. You use this on your lashes and you get glitter, and I really, really love it. And these ones were so pretty, so I bought these from H&M. Yes, and I bought these from Revolution. I've been wanting to try this forever, and then I saw them in store and I just bought them online. I'm not a big fan of Revolution right now, for it's like, you know, I buy so much from them every week, and for 3 years I've been having a pro discount code that gets me 20% off. And when they changed their website, they took away all the pro codes and they didn't tell anyone. The struggle I have been through to try to contact them, and I hate the new webpage. It crashes all the time. It's so hard to use it. But yeah, I'm so annoyed by them right now, but there's nothing I can do. And it's, you know, thank God they are kind of affordable, even though I think the prices have gone up. Oh, someone just said that I had a great haul, but you know, I'm recording one right now. But yeah, never mind. But I bought 3 of the 5 of these. What am I going to do about the light? I don't know. But it's Desired, Adored by You, and Yours Truly. And this one is, you know, there is a shimmery side and a glittery side. And this one is like a peachy pink. I'm really looking forward to use it. They look pretty. Yeah. Then I bought, where is that? I can take that for. When I was in Sephora in Denmark, I bought these Crayola, because I don't think they will be coming to Sweden. I don't know. But I bought the Eye Crayon Trio in Royal Peacock. So it's Outer Space, Copper, and Eggplant. Let's take them out. And they look really cute. They look like crayons. I don't know what to do about the light, so I'm so sorry. But it's like a dark purple and a bronze and outer space. So I guess it's a black silvery one. Let's try it. I usually don't like this type of pen, but I thought they looked cool, so. Face crayon, okay. Yeah, it's like a gray black shimmery one. They looked really nice anyway. And I want to have them in the packaging. I'm going to change the light and see if it will be better. I'm back. Then I bought some things from W7. This one, banana powder. Sorry, it's empty because it came totally smashed. I was expecting it because Paulina ordered the same and it was also smashed. Doesn't matter that much. I got my money back, kind of. And I saved some of the powder and put it into a container, but it's super yellow, so I can't use it. But I still wanted it. It's obviously trying to be a dupe of the Too Faced ones. And I have also showed this in a video. This is the Summer Sunshine. I have counted this as a bronzer, but now I'm considering changing that. But it's a duo glow highlighter, and it's trying to dupe. It smells nice. The one from Too Faced. Mm-hmm. But yeah. Then we have the two palettes. It's Hot Tropic and Grape Escape. And they are obviously duping. Can I say obviously more? The Too Faced ones. This is one of them. And the other one I have used in a dupe video where I compare them. This one with the original, and they smell nice. And they are really similar, and I really like this, so, and I think I paid like $3 for it, so if you want to dupe, these are good. But they have actually had a sale on Too Faced, the Tutti Frutti collection on our Sephora, so I bought the duos that I didn't already have. I had three. I had two blush duos and the bronze duos, so I bought, you know, the other five. And it's Berries and Bubbly. Looks like that. I've used most of them and they are really nice. Oh, it smells like bubbles. Then we have Papaya Pop. Looks like that. And they smell. Oh, smell nice. This looks like this. And then we have Apricot in the Act. And like I said, I already have two or three of them. And this is Like My Melons. This smells exactly like artificial melon. Did I just dip my nose into it? And the last one is Cherry Bomb. I have them in the order, they are dark. Looks like that. So now I'm going to put these back. Yeah. Then I bought this from ColourPop, Orange Glad. I'm actually paid customs for my ColourPop order, so I should receive the strawberry shake and the peach palette. But this is the Orange Chouglade. You have all seen it, but yeah. I like it. Let's put it here because these I have not shown. And then I bought this one, Pretty Please. It's obviously a dupe for the Naked Cherry. Can they make a dupe of the Naked Reloaded? Because I don't have that. I have all the other dupes, so. Then in Denmark I bought this. Oh, that changed the light. This is Socialite. And this is a dupe for the Huda New Nudes. Now I have two dupes, but I don't have the original. And they cannot say they are not dupes when they actually have the cream shade down here. But I would like to compare this to the Revolution one. Ooh. I thought, is this not glitter? Ooh, I think I like this better than the Revolution one, because that is actually a cream shade. I thought this was just a pressed glitter. Well, maybe. Yeah, but this one I have anyway. I can show you the other ones I have from W7 now when I'm at it. I bought Enchanted Brilliance in Bloom. It looks like that. I don't think this is a dupe for anything. But then we have two dupes. This is the Violet Lights Neutrals Gone Wild. It's a dupe for the Norvina palette. And we have Seduced. Yeah, I wonder. Yeah, it's a dupe for the Sultry one. That is going in that order. Yeah. Then I made an order from Tarte. And they... I've seen this palette. I was so sad that I didn't order it when it came out. Then they had a sale a few weeks ago. Or months ago. And I saw this again at the sale. And I was like, oh, I have to order it. But I didn't find anything else I want to order. Can you please stop? Gumald! Good man. Hello. Then it came back. Pew! Did I order this for the packaging? Absolutely. But I also like the name. Be a Mermaid and Make Waves. It's really weird. Yeah, it's best when it's open. Then it can stand if I can open it. But you all know what it looks like. It's... I don't like the pan size or pan shape. But I do love the smell. It annoys me because it says 99% mermaid. And I'm like, what is the last percent? Should I know that? I don't know. But it looks like that. And I'm so happy I finally got it. And when I ordered from there, they had a discount. And sometimes the discount can't be applied to certain palettes, but now it could. And just when I ordered this, this was on sale in Sweden as well, but yeah. This is the High Tides and Good Vibes eyeshadow palette. You know, it's the one that moves like the light with the turtle. It's so heavy. It looks like that, you know, with the pressed glitters. It looks so pretty. And I actually am curious about these shades, because you all look at the glitter, so you can't really see the other shades, but yeah, I just like it. Can you not fall, but move? And then the last thing I ordered from Tarte is, it looks so damn cheap because it looks like they have just glued on. Have they? No, I don't want to destroy this. This is the Let It Rain Bow eyeshadow palette. It looks like this. It looks like another one they have, but yeah. It's the colorful one. And when you bought this, you had to buy it in a pack where you got the mascara as well. I like the mascara, so never mind. But if I could choose, I wouldn't have bought it. It's their Light Camera Lashes mascara. It's like I said in my collection video. I rarely buy mascaras just like that, you know. And you don't fall, please. And then I bought this. Can you see how sparkly this is? This is not on the Swedish website, Sephora website. It's only did something just come into the camera? Weird, I have to look at the footage later. But this is the Showstopper Omega Glaze Highlighter. It's just the gold one that is on the website. So I bought one and one for Linda. So hard to show you, but it's like a pinky, glittery peach awesomeness. Oh, expensive. It's so expensive. I think it's like $60. But it's pretty. And when I was in Sephora, I also bought this. This is also so expensive. It's $40 or something. And I'm kind of disappointed because it looks like it's dirty. I don't know if it shows, but yeah. It's kind of a cheap packaging, actually. But it's so pretty on the inside. It smells weird, but yeah. It's so pretty. I don't want to use it. Ooh. You could actually feel that. That's cool. But the packaging is really nothing special. It's a Natural Lust bronzer. It's so big. The front is pretty, but otherwise it's really cheap. And by the way, I bought these. There is nothing in here, but it's from W7. Cookie Puffs Face Blender Sponges. It's the one I have over there that I showed you in my makeup collection video. You have to go there to see them. But it's the sponges that look like macarons that I have purely for decoration. And now I can throw this away. Det var bara jag gummel. Then I bought two palettes from UVS Place. I have ordered the Warrior 3, which is the colorful one. And then I have not ordered the Nomad one, which is so confusing because that should be the Warrior 3. But I think we all think that, so yeah. But I ordered the Queen palette, Fumi and UVS. It's so heavy and thick. It's like, are there other stuff in here? Because it's so much heavier than I ordered another one. And this is so much heavier. Is there more product in here? Yeah, a little, but not much. But it's like, I can't show you. But it's more heavy than any of the other palettes. And this is one of the smallest ones, so it's weird. But it looks like this, and I love the inside. So I will put this in, both of these palettes I will put into my UVS Play series. But this looks so pretty. I don't think I have swatched these. Ooh, I just swatched the FDV approved. I don't know if you can see it, but it's really pretty. Then I bought the Nubian 3 Coral, and this is so much prettier in real life than it is on any picture I have seen. So I'm really happy I got it because it's silvers and corals. But it looks so boring, even when I'm holding it up. But it's more pretty in real life than it looks on any picture. God, I love that shade. Ooh, yeah. This will also be in my UVS Play series. And if you have an suggestion to what I should do with this, because if you follow my Molly and Linda's UVS Play series, you know that we have done different things with the palettes and will continue to do that. And I have not decided what I'm going to do with these two. I think I know what I'm going to do with this, but I have not decided what to do with this. So if you have any suggestions, maybe a two-tone look. So I make one gray and one coral. Maybe I do that. We'll see. Then I bought from Blush Tribe. So I bought the Layla 2. It's so pretty. I've not swatched this either. That shade looks magical. Hello. It looks like this. I swatched that shade, but yeah, I really want to use this. I love green and yellow. Oh, it's so pretty. And the Pastel Tribe. I have used this, right? I think I've used this palette. But I didn't record it. But yeah, I used this palette actually. It looks like that. It is very light. I remember thinking that I think I would rather use this as company palette, companion palette. Yeah, you know, because these shades are so light, but it's really pretty. And then I bought the Ace Beauté Oceanic palette. Oh my god, I so want to use this. Every time I look at this, I'm like, why haven't you used it? I want to use the Flare palette more. I've used it once. Oh my god. I should have had the Kaleidos palettes, but you know, Swedish Postal Service are crap. Yeah, so now we are a bit ahead. Now we are... It's still a lot left. I found this at Sephora as well. Now it's also on the website. But yeah, Shake Your Pom-Poms. I love this packaging. And it smells so nice. Looks like this. Not that exciting, but you know, that's not why I bought it. Oh, nice. Then, here comes some ColourPop. I bought, when I bought the Orange You Glad, I bought You're So Appealing lip kit with two lipsticks that I hoped that I didn't have, and I didn't have them, and I love the lipsticks. And it's in this kit you have Chi Chi and Parker. They are both matte. It's not my favorite, but you know, I like lipsticks. So this should be like a brown. These you can buy separate, I think. They had just put them in a kit. And this is a super red. Oh, I hate when they like that. Now I can throw away the box. And then I bought a lipstick called Money Side Up. It's like dusty pink. I was going to say mauve pink, but I have learned that that's not what it's called. The mirror is really far away. God, I don't want to start work. And I can feel that this is a matte, but it's really pretty. Yeah, pretty. Then I bought two mini powders because I will never use up loose powders otherwise. And I really want to try them out, but it's so interesting because I bought Peach Perfect from Too Faced. This one. And I bought the Fenty one Pro Filter in Butter. These cost, let's say that they cost the same, but this one was some dollars more. In this one you have 3.5 grams. This one you have like 8 grams. Are you joking? It's more than double than what it is in this. And I think I will buy a big size of this when I have used this up. Because this is the first loose powder that I have really, really loved. So thank you, Paulina, for recommending it to me. Did I say that it was the shade Butter? Yeah, it's the lightest one. And I love the packaging. But I'm so happy about those. Oh, and when I bought the Tutti Frutti duos, I also bought this. It's the highlighting palette, hyper reflective highlighting palette, vanilla, strawberry and chocolate. It's super glittery highlights. Yeah, they are so pretty. I can look at this all day long. Hello. And it's the same size as the eyeshadow palettes. I love them. Let's pull you there. Then I have bought a weapon. This eyeshadow palette is so big. I saw Hannah from Smoky Glow use this. And I was like, I need to have that, but it's so expensive. And then I saw Paulina buy it, and I was like, okay, you got me. And then they had it on sale on Beauty Bay, and it's so heavy that I could seriously use it as a weapon. It's this one from Stila. It's so big. It's really heavy. It's even more heavy than the Pharaoh palette. It's extremely heavy. And this is the Happy Hour. So afraid I will drop it, but it looks like this. And it's really expensive, but at least it's big. I would be so annoyed if it was a small palette. But yeah, these shadows look so amazing. I'm sorry about the light. I'm sorry about the light in this video. Hello. But if I lock it, I don't think it will get better. I say now that we have been filming for 40 minutes. Is it better? Is it really better? Well, I'm not refilming this. But yeah. So this one I'm so excited to use. And like I said, and when I bought this, I also bought this. And this is like nothing. This is the Little White Lies highlighting palette from Stila. I already have the Shine Bright. This is super glittery. Oh, it looks so nice in the mirror. But I don't know. Can you see? It's like a pink reflect, a yellow, and almost like a blue. It's the one that you could squeeze down if you want to, but I don't want to. Can we lock the light again? I feel like I'm so boring in this video. Is that because I'm tired? Then I bought one thing that I never thought I was going to buy. But I did, because I cheated the system. You're going to be so disappointed. And since I bought this and another palette in the same from the same brand, I now have to buy the last palette I don't have. I bought this. Obviously, it's limited edition, and I swatched some shades in the store, and now I think I like it. It looks so boring. But everyone says it's amazing, and you know the silver, and it's almost like a gray top shade, and I can't say that. And it's just pretty. And I don't even like, and is it a silver pink? Yeah. Okay, it just happened. I got it cheaper. And I got it. Don't I have anything to? No? Okay. And I bought this. It was when I bought this. I was not going to buy this either, because I'm not a big fan of Jackie Aina. I don't hate her, but I don't like her. But by the way, this is so pretty. But you know, the shade that I'm not even going to say, but the red metallic. I'm going to swatch it next to the Kat Von D shade that I can't remember what it's called now. Swoon? No, I don't remember. But it has to be a dupe. And now when I look at it, oh my god, it looks so pretty. Is that a peach with gold? Oh my god, yes. Oh my god, okay, I like this palette, okay? I have not used it, but it's pretty. It's so much prettier in real life. So now I have these, and now I have to buy Soft Glam. I'm sorry. I have to do that. And I have shadow everywhere.
Wait.
Yeah. Okay, I'm back. Then I bought some palettes from Revolution. I bought Intoxicated with Love. It's that one. Cool tone and cool. Then I bought Black is the New Black. You know, I love grays and cool tones. Yeah, jag vet, gubbal. Looks like that. It almost like the new... Now it's Lime Crime. I always call the fun size palette, which I have ordered, for Lime Crime, but that's Sugar Pill. So yeah. Then London's Calling. And I watched my friend Angie, and she actually did a look where she compared this to the Androgyny palette from Jeffree Star, and the bottom row is exactly the same. And the other ones, you know, look like that palette. But apparently they have done the flag wrong. I don't know that because it's not my flag, but that's kind of bad since it is a UK brand. But yeah, it's London's Calling anyway. And since I bought these three, I also bought this Sweet Like. And it looks like this. Yeah. And then I bought the two new Forever Flawless. So this is Fire. Ow. And it looks like that. And Ice. And this one you could obviously compare to the Blue Blood. I have not done it, but I think Anya did. Looks like that. Really pretty. I love this type of packaging. Now I'm almost done, people. Then, of course, I was not going to buy this either, but I did. It's Anette's fault. This is the Morphe Jeffree Star palette. And now I'm kind of happy that I have it because it's really pretty. But yeah, I'm going to show you it upside down. You all know what it looks like. I had to have it. It's pretty. Then I got, oh, I have not shown these. Let's take them first. ColourPop, three new cream liners, Swerve the black, Exit the white. I think I put up a video today where I used these actually. And Nut. They are really pretty. Then today I got some stuff from Makeup a Murder. So I got the new eyeshadow palette called Crime Scene Trace Evidence Eyeshadow Palette Volume 1 Paint Chips. And it looks like that. I don't think you can see it, but the front is holographic because you can see the rainbow. And this is what it looks on the inside. It's a classic, you know, rainbow palette. It's all matte. But it's not that, oh my god, it's the brightest neon shade. They're more, I don't know what to call it. They're more dull in a good way. It's like not a very bright yellow. It's like a soft yellow. And they are called, you know, bedroom, garage, minivan, basement. I'm going to do a video with this, and I also bought, they had a sale, I bought one pigments, and this is the black one called Ammonia. It's so cool with the skull. I wanted the bleach one, but it was out of stock when I ordered. Then I bought all the neon ones, and I think I can compare these to the blush tribe, but they look like these. Oh, and this one has leaked, I can see now, but I will fix that. I think these are just called, you know, the shades. So it's this, red, and then orange. Sorry, I want to have them in the order of the rainbow. Now we have the yellow, the green. I think these are glowing in the dark. Blue. Purple and pink. And then I actually got, or I didn't get, I ordered, it's called Extraction Kit. So it's a jar where you can put the pigments, which is easier to, you know, use it. But yeah. Yeah. Now I only have some nice things left, and I'm really going to try to not cry. So I will just drink and then we will take them. Okay. So I got some stuff from Paulina. And two things I knew I was getting because she told me, but the other things she sent me without telling me. And the things I knew I was getting, I got this today. It's the Milk Blur Stick in Mini. And Milk has come to Sweden and I want to try the Blur Stick. It's the only thing that I'm kind of interested in. And she said she had a Mini that I could try. So I will try it, and if I like it, I will buy it. So thank you so much, Paulina. I got this today. Let's put it there. The other thing that I knew I was getting was this. This was the only palette from Blush Tribe that I didn't have. And Paulina got it, and she asked me if I wanted it. And I'm almost crying when I'm talking about it. And I was like, oh my god, yes. Look, it's so pretty. I didn't buy this because it's supposed to be shades from three other palettes. But I still wanted it, so I knew that I was going to buy it sooner or later. Oh my god, Gunvald is making noises. Vad fan är du? Gunvald! And I was not losing my voice. I was so happy when she said that she was going to send this to me. And when I got it, she had put in other stuff and wrote a note to me, you know, to the woman who has everything. Woman. Now I can't say it. Who has everything. I hope you don't have these things, and I don't have these things. One thing I've shown a lot, it's the lipstick Greatest from Makeup Revolution. I have other lipstick from this range and I love them, and I've used this so much on my channel because this is my type of nude. I love it so much, and it's so creamy, and I love the smell. It smells like nostalgia, if that's the word. I love it. Then I got a liquid lipstick from OPV. I have not tried this yet. It's in the shade Shine. It's a really dark, pretty shade. Oh my god. Yeah. So pretty. Then I got a glitter from BH Cosmetics that I have been wanting to try, but I have none of these. It's Diamond Dazzlers in, it's loose foil pigment, but it looks like glitter. And this is in the shade Precious, I think. It's a silvery one, right? So pretty. Then I have been wanting to buy a blur primer for very long because I ran out of my professional, or run out. It was getting old. And then I got one from... Now from Paulina, and it's from Cover FX. Oh, great light. Can you focus on this? Look, I have tried this and this works. Yeah. This works really good for me. And it's so a blurring primer that instantly minimizes the appearance of pores and fine lines. And I use it on my nose and it's excellent. Thank you so much. Then she sent me something that I have put in my cart a million times, but I have not bought it. It's this. It's a shadow from Sugar Pill called... It's probably, what was it called? it's short for something that I don't know what it is. It's, that's the name. S-W-A-K. And it looks like this. And if you know me, you know what I think of peachy pink shades. And this is like, are you freaking kidding me? This is everything I love about that. And do you know how many times I put this in my cart and just, no, I can't take that right now. I have almost all the sugar pill shades, but I don't have this one. I'm so, so grateful. And it's just like, you know, I get so sentimental when I get gifts, because I usually, it sounds like I never get gifts, but I have family and friends that give me gifts, you know, for birthdays, and my family gives me stuff like that, but I never get makeup stuff. And it's just the thought that someone I admire and see as my friend wants to send me things like that. Oh my God, I just cried. I'm so grateful. I am very bad at expressing gratitude, is it called that? Like that, because I don't know what to say, because I'm so thankful and I just want to show it in every way. But I'm so bad at doing that. But Paulina, if you are watching this, I'm so, so grateful. And now I feel a cry. But we're not going to do that. So let's move on. I think I have showed you everything. If I haven't, I will show that in my haul for next month. But you know the neon pigments that I got from Make Up a Murder? They came in this. How cool is that? Evidence! Yeah, sorry. I think that is cool. But yeah, that is all. And I've been filming for 1 hour, but I would know I will cut out some bits. But every time I say that, it's like 30 seconds. And it's probably very late now. Bye and bye.